Hello everyone, welcome back to another painting tutorial video. In this video I will show you how I paint my Myrmourn Banshees. Here I listed all the colors that I'm using on these miniatures. Bear in mind they are not in order that I use them. Although I'm going through one by one in order during the video. The Banshees are sub-assembled and primed in black. The first color I'm using is Celestra Grey, and just start base painting the spiritual waves towards the middle of the body. I'm just trying to make sharp lines going upwards. Then I'm using a 1-to-1 mix of Incubi Darkness and Abaddon Black and start base painting the top section and where the Celestra Grey stripes are. I'm just trying to go over them with the same color so that have a nice blending effect. Then I'm using only Incubi Darkness and mainly focusing in the bottom section where the blending section is. I'm trying to make it more lighter so that the transition is really smooth in that area. Now I'm going to use Nihiliakh Oxide and base paint all the Celestra Grey area and carefully overpaint where the transition goes as well. Thank you. Once the Nihiliakh Oxide is dry, I'm using a 3-to-1 mix of Lahmian Medium and Coelia Greenshade wash. And with this, I'm washing the whole miniature once, then at least 4-5 times between where the transition is going, so that it really blends together well. I use Ulthuan Grey and just dry brush all the spiritual waves. I'm using a 1-to-1 mix of Incubi Darkness and Kabalite Green and start layering and highlighting also all the cloth areas except the top part, so the head. I'm leaving it as dark as it is. I am using now Kabalite Green and just highlight all the cloth areas. Now I'm going to use a 1-to-1 mix of Sybarite and Kabalite Green and start highlighting, making them much closer towards the spirit waves. Thank you. and finishing it with Sybarite Green, a fine highlight. I am using now Waywatcher Green GLAZE and wash all the robe and spiritual wave parts. And using a 2-to-1 mix of Lahmian Medium and Mortarion Green, and mainly where the transition is going. I'm using Rhinox Hide on the corset. I base paint the metal areas with Leadbelcher. I give a wash of Nuln Oil for the corset and also the chest. I mixed Zandri Dust and Rhinox Hide, 1-to-1 mix, and with that I am highlighting the corset. giving a fine highlight with Gorthor Brown. Highlighting also the Leadbelcher with Stormhost Silver. Using now Zandri Dust. Mainly just on the head, the bottom jaw part. I give it a wash of Agrax Earthshade. When the Agrax Earthshade is drying, I'm using Ionrach Skin on the arms. The Agrax Earthshade is dried, I'm using Morghast Bone on the lower jaw part. With Screaming Skull, I base paint the teeth and highlight some of the jaw areas. I dilute Drakenhof Nightshade with Lahmian Medium, a 1-to-3 mix, and I give a wash on the arms. Once the wash is dry, I'm using again Ionrach Skin and just dry brush all the arms. I'm using Deepkin Flesh and highlight all the hands. Palette Witch Flesh, I highlight only the knuckles. And I give a light wash of Reikland Fleshshade till the mid section of the arms so that it gets a nice transition as well. I'm using Nagaroth Knight on the sash and also the handle of the daggers. I use Incubi Darkness on the blades of the daggers. As you can see, I also painted the handle parts of the daggers with metal, so it's the same technique as the chest part. I use Kabalite Green and highlight the blade. With Sybarite Green, I give a fine highlight, mainly just on the tip. I'm using Retributor Armour on the hourglass and just base paint on the metal parts of it. I'm using Zandri Dust on the sand of the hourglass. give a wash of Reikland Fleshshade on the metal parts only of the hourglass. Now that all the details are painted on the miniature, I assembled it, and on the head part I'm focusing now with Dark Reaper. I just start dry brushing on the head. Then I'm using Mechanicus Standard Grey and give a fine highlight just on the sharpest features of the head, such as the teeth area, the eyes, the nose. Miniature is finished now, and at this stage it is entirely optional how you want to paint your bases, but this is my version, so I'm using Rhinox Hide on the base and just dry brush it on the soil area. Then I'm using Nuln Oil and wash all over it. Then I'm using Mournfang Brown and dry brush all the soil areas. Giving a very fine dry brush to the soil areas with Karak Stone. I base paint the gravestones with Mechanicus Standard Grey. First, give a Agrax Earthshade wash. Then I give a second wash with Athonian Camoshade. Once the wash is completely dry, I'm going back with Mechanical Standard Grey and start dry brushing all the gravestones. Giving another dry brush with Dawnstone. And a very light one with Administratum Grey. Base paint all the skulls and bones with Zandri Dust. Give it a wash with Agrax Earthshade. I layer all the bone areas with Morghast Bone. Screaming skull, I give a highlight and all the bones are finished with it. I start base painting all the veins with Death World Forest, and also try to keep not to go too over some of the veins, so that where it has been dry brushed with Mournfang Brown, it still gets that nice transition. I use Athonian Camoshade and wash all the veins, plus also the leaves, which are also base painted with Mournfang Brown. I use Elysian Green and just highlight all the veins. I am using a 1-to-1 mix of Mournfang Brown and Elysian Green, and with that mixture I highlight also the leaves. I base paint all the roses with Khorne Red. Then I give a wash with Druchii Violet. And with Mephiston Red, I highlight the roses. I use Abaddon Black on the rim of the bases, and with that the miniatures are finished. So here I have my widows grieving with full of hatred because of their lost loved ones. I really liked painting them. I hope this recipe can help you as well. Please do give a like if you liked it. That really helps a lot with the channel. Also, don't forget to subscribe. Until the next video, cheers!